British lawmakers expressing outrage because President Trump retweeted three videos from a far-right anti-Muslim group from the UK. Listen to one member of parliament slamming the president this morning.
This is the president of the United States sharing with millions inflammatory and divisive content deliberately posted to sow hatred and division by, as the Home Secretary says, a convicted criminal who is facing further charges, who represents a vile fascist organisation seeking to spread hatred and violence in person and online. By sharing it, he is either a racist, incompetent, or unthinking, or all three.
Stephen Doughty joins us now. Thank you for taking the opportunity, sir. What moved you to make that statement?
I think there's been absolute outrage at the president's sharing of this information. And let's not forget, this is not a normal Donald Trump Twitter storm. This is a far-right fascist organization with a convicted criminal who is currently facing further charges in the UK for inciting religious hatred. He has shared information from her account, which has clearly been put out to sow religious hatred and to stir up division in Britain and globally. It's an extraordinary thing for a president of the United States to have done, and he has endured condemnation on all sides today from members of the cabinet, from the prime minister, and from across the House of Commons.
The White House says it doesn't matter the source, it doesn't matter even if the videos are authentic, because the threat is authentic, and that is what they call Islamic terror. And the response from the president was, you people over there in the UK should worry about that more, and what he says less. Your response?
Well, I think the president needs to worry about what's happening in the United States more than he's worrying about far-right organizations in the UK and sharing their content. The fact is that I utterly condemn hatred and extremism and violence from wherever it comes, whether it comes from Islamist organizations, whether it comes from the far right, or whether it comes from anti-Semitic organizations. I'm you know, equal in my condemnation of all of those. But what the president has done here is sharing information from a convicted criminal, someone who is currently facing further charges, and from a very extreme organisation, equivalent, I would say, to the likes of the KKK in the United States. And it's quite extraordinary for him to be doing that. The woman has been on air herself online overnight, asking the president to effectively get her out of prison. That's an extraordinary situation to be in.
The call by a member of parliament for the president of the United States to be arrested on UK soil for spreading religious hate, too far?
I certainly don't support the president coming here for a state visit. I don't know whether he's committed criminal offences. The Home Secretary, of course, said that she would, you know, keep under review any comments that have been made by anybody and treat them like she would with any individual making allegations or stirring up hatred and division. But it's very clear that British lawmakers from all parties, all parts of the House, members of the Cabinet, are deeply unhappy at what the president has done. We would not welcome him here for a state visit. We, of course, want to have cooperation and a relationship with the administration. You know, I love America. I love Americans. My grandfather was an American GI who came over to fight fascism in the Second World War. And I've traveled across 25 of your fantastic states. And President Trump simply doesn't represent the kind, generous, caring Americans that I know.
Well, he was elected president. And in terms of the level of discontent, the prime minister speaking this morning, Theresa May, in response to the president of the United States. Let's play a little bit of what she said.
But we need to address this issue of the terrorist threat from whatever source it comes, because yes, we have to deal with the Islamist terrorist threat. We also have to deal with the fact that we have seen attacks in the United Kingdom from the far right as well. So we take seriously and deal with terrorism and extremism from whatever its source.
The Prime Minister there seemed to be giving a nod to what you were speaking to, that this woman and her group that the president gave an audience to, you see as much of a threat as Islamic terror in the UK?
Absolutely. And let's not forget that one of my colleagues in Parliament last year, Joe Cox, who many of your viewers will have seen the reports of, was murdered by a far-right neo-Nazi individual who, in fact, shouted references to the organisation that President Trump has been seemingly endorsing. And obviously, that cuts very, very close. It's extraordinarily irresponsible of him to have done so, let alone the fact that we have ongoing criminal proceedings involving this individual. For President Trump to be sharing her information information without verification and without thought to the organization or the consequences of doing that is the height of irresponsibility.
Now, there is a reason that the president, there are probably several reasons that the president is saying and doing what he does where when it comes to extreme Islamism and terror. And that is that there are many Americans that are afraid of Muslims. And you have been dealing with as much and more in terms of homegrown and brought in terror from that. Do you sense among your own population that there is a growing resistance to saying it's not all Islam, it's only a little bit, that that is being dismissed as political correctness? Because that is a battle going on here in the United States.
Well, I have utterly condemned Islamist organizations and those spreading fear and hate purporting to be Muslims. They're not Muslims in my view, nor are they the view of my Muslim constituents in my district in South Wales. I have a very, very diverse district that I represent, and we have had problems with far-right and Islamist extremism and terrorism. But the way to fight that is to by standing united against it and not seeking to divide and further incite fear and hatred, and by supporting and appearing to endorse an organisation like Britain First that has nothing but an agenda to demonise all Muslims, all peace-loving and law-abiding Muslims as somehow a cancer, as the deputy leader of that organisation has said, is extraordinary.